One of the most varied sources of aquatic wildlife in the entire world is right here in Tennessee. The 269-mile-long Duck River contains more species of fish than are found in all the rivers of Europe combined, and more fish varieties per mile than any other river in North America. Producers Rod and Tilly Starns and videographer Will Bezubik take us to Middle Tennessee for a journey down the Duck to see what the Nature Conservancy is doing to protect this important resource.
As the sun rises on a cool spring morning in Tennessee, the Duck River reveals its beauty. The beautiful scenery of this peaceful environment can take your breath away. But there is much more to this lovely landscape. What lies below the swirling waters of this shallow river is truly amazing. It's a living museum of freshwater animal life unsurpassed anywhere on the continent. Don Hubbs, our tour guide, is snorkeling in the water to show us a species of aquatic animal that might seem unexciting or even unnoticeable to the untrained eye. Freshwater mussels.
These will get about this big and weigh 10 to 12 pounds and live 80 to 100 years.
Don's job with the Tennessee Wildlife Resources Agency is monitoring and protecting the state's mussel population.
Just the sheer variety of the number of different species is what really got me interested in freshwater mussels and the role they play in the environment. You know, it's something that to most people might come to a river their whole life and never realize how many mussels are down there on the bottom. All of Europe has only 14 species of freshwater mussels, and here the Duck River alone has 55 species.
The vast variety of mussels, along with 151 species of fish and 22 species of aquatic snails, make the Duck River the most biologically diverse river in North America. And like most rivers in an urban area, the Duck faces a variety of threats. Urban stormwater runoff, sewage treatment discharges, and chemical runoff from farmland can all negatively impact freshwater creatures and the 250,000 people who use the Duck River as their sole water source. Don handles the mussels with care and knows each species by name. Names only a mother could love, like pimpleback, purple wartyback, and pyramid pigtoe. Many of the mussels got their colorful names in the early 20th century from fishermen known as shellers who harvested the shells for use as buttons. They gave them names that described the mussel's texture and appearance, like
washboard because it has these ridges on the side like an old washboard that you would scrub your clothes on. Now where a name like wavy rayed lamp mussel, you know, came from, if you can kind of look through the shell and see the light shining through a little bit, you know, it's kind of like a lampshade. Painted creek shell, the coloration and the markings, you know, look like something that you might paint on something, the broad green stripes. So you come up with a variety of names. A bird wing, of course, might look like a small bird's wing.
The bird-wing pearly mussel is one of three endangered mussel species that live in the Duck River. These creatures with very colorful names don't make any noise, and they move very slowly with one slimy foot. It's a very unassuming presence for what is actually an ecological powerhouse.
Well, their main function for a river is they are the natural filtration system. They're continuously pumping water through their bodies and filtering out things like algae and bacteria which can be harmful to us as humans. So they're providing a service to us by cleaning the water. A large mussel like this washboard can filter up to 50 gallons of water a day. And then you imagine a population of hundreds of animals in a square yard of habitat, all of them filtering that much water, they can effectively clean a river.
Being a natural water filter is just one of many reasons why mussels are important creatures to our ecosystem. They're also a sort of canary in a coal mine. A sudden kill of freshwater mussels is a sure sign of toxic pollution in a waterway. They're a vital link in the food chain, serving as a key food source for animals like otters, ducks, and many fish. And finally, they may actually help unlock a key to a devastating disease in humans. Scientists are studying freshwater mussels to determine why they seem immune to cancer, despite being exposed to pollutants in the water they filter.
A lot of our cures for a lot of diseases come from the natural world. And if we lose some of these mussels, then that's a potential genome full of cures.
That's why protecting the river is so important to Leslie Colley. She grew up nearby.
I love seeing how clear the water is. I love seeing all the birds flying along in front of us as we go down the river.
The mussel diversity is extraordinary because they're the most imperiled large group of animals on the planet. Freshwater mussels are.
That is because of dams and pollution, essentially.
Leslie works for the Nature Conservancy to protect the river and all the creatures that inhabit it.
The Nature Conservancy is the largest conservation organization in the world. We are a nonprofit. We have offices in all 50 states and a growing international program. We are successful because we approach conservation in a non-confrontational, quiet way. We work with a lot of partners, sometimes unlikely partners, and we affect change by working with local people on the ground and getting things done. And that's one of my favorite things about working for the Conservancy, because we really accomplish tangible things that make a difference.
Leslie and the Tennessee chapter of the Nature Conservancy work with communities, businesses, and government agencies on long-term protection of the river's water quality and ecological integrity. The successful strategies the Nature Conservancy uses here at the Duck River can be transferred to their work around the globe.
We've protected over 135 million acres worldwide and over 5,000 miles of critically important rivers and streams worldwide. We here on the Duck partner with a global freshwater team with the Nature Conservancy that's doing work in Mexico and in Canada and in Australia and South Africa. So everything that we do here, we keep an eye to making it broad and meaningful strategies that are transferable to other places. So the things that we learn here in this laboratory of sorts can be used elsewhere as we do our work.
One of the ways Leslie has been successful is by helping people to care deeply about the river.
We cannot tease man and nature apart. And I think particularly in a system like this river, which is a water source for a lot of people and which is a recreational spot for people and is surrounded by farmland and small southern towns, we've got to find really substantial ways to link people to this river and to keep the human uses and needs of this river foremost in our mind, as well as the needs of the ecological system. I believe strongly that we as individuals have an obligation to be good stewards. It's really not a matter of why we should care, it's a matter of the fact that we have to care. There is a growing and very real sense of urgency about the work that we do. Both on this river and really everywhere that we work.